friends, welcome to another week of Kids Church at Home on video. We're so glad that you can join us for another week of exploring faith and community and life and just being together in this way. I want to say a special shout out and a hello to Abigail and Charlie and Gianluca and Gabby and Eli and Chloe. It's really great that you guys are with us, and we welcome all our new friends as well. This week, we're looking at a story about some of Jesus's friends who came to a point where they had to choose. They had to choose to look at what they had lost and be sad about that, or to choose to move forward and create something new out of what they had lost and take all the things that they had learned and put it into a new life. So that's what our theme is today. It's a complicated theme, but we're going to explore that a little bit more today in the story and our craft and ourselves and our song. This song is from More Voices, and it's a spiritual. It's a call and response song. So your response will be, I hear music in the air. And that's a really nice and easy word. So every time I will say a line and you can respond with, I hear music in the air. And this is also a really great song for some percussion. So if you have shakers, or if you want to clap or stomp your feet, or get some spoons that you can play on your knees, or we discovered this week that if you put some water in a balloon and you bang it, it makes a really neat sound. But maybe don't tell your parents about that one, because that one can get wet and messy. But it's a really neat drum. You put a nice big balloon with some water in it. So I'll invite you to come and sing with me. Over my head, I hear music in the air. Over my head. Song. Play with harmonies, play with repeats. It's one of those fun songs that's super simple, but it invites all of us to add our own voice into it in whatever way that we can.
Well, here's our turn.
You're right. So we've got Toby and Pitch, who are here to play with our story a little bit too. Oh my goodness. How fun are these guys? Hi. Hi, do you want to come play with the Lego?
There it goes.
See you later. Bye, kitties. So Eli, we are going to go back to playing our story again, like we did a few weeks ago, right? You ready to do that for me?
Yeah.
And so you have brought me a collection of Lego people who are going to be our disciples. Do you want to introduce some of our disciples and followers of Jesus here?
I have Iron Man and Ant-Man, Hawkeye, Scarlet Witch, Spider-Man, Captain Marvel, Black Widow, Doctor Strange, Thor, Bucky, and the Cap, and...
And who's Jesus?
Jesus is Nick Fury.
Okay.
And I have...
And then we've got some other characters who are going to join us for the story. That's cool. I really like that the disciples are the Avengers, right? They're all the people who've got all kinds of special skills. They're going to go and change the world, aren't they? So our story this week is called The Ascension. That's kind of a weird word. Do you any idea what you think ascension means?
No.
No?
Maybe.
Maybe? Okay. What's your guess?
I have no idea.
If we're ascending something, are we going up? Ascending?
Oh, that makes sense.
Yeah, so ascension means the going up. But that's a really weird title for a story, but I think it'll make sense when I tell the story. So, after Jesus died, there was a period of time when Jesus' friends and followers experienced that Jesus was physically still present with them. But then, after some time, that feeling went away. And that's where the story of the Ascension comes into play. And so the story that people told was that one day, Jesus was with his followers. And they began to see Jesus rising towards the sky. And Jesus said to them, "Don't worry. Don't worry. You guys are now the leaders." But they still were pretty scared and worried. And as Jesus rose into the sky, his followers saw two white figures join Jesus in the sky. I wonder who those white figures might be. Maybe they were previous prophets, so teachers like Jesus. And I wonder why they joined him in the sky. Isn't that kind of interesting? But those two white leaders, or white people that joined Jesus in the sky, they looked at the followers, all these Avengers who were just staring blankly at the sky going, "Why are you disappearing?" And they said, "Why are you standing there looking at the sky? You know what to do. Go out into the world and share Jesus' story." And so that's what they did. I wonder, you can come down with Jesus and the followers. I wonder, what do you think is the most important part of the story?
He climbed.
He climbed and disappeared. That's a pretty important part. I wonder what it was like for these
Avengers
in that moment. You know, sometimes I think that we can feel like those Avengers. I think sometimes we can feel like something we've known and was really important to us is suddenly disappearing. And we can either stand there like the disciples and stare at the sky and wonder, why is it disappearing? Why isn't it the same as it used to be? And we can get frustrated and sad about it changing and things that were important to us going away. Or we can do what these guys did and what the white people in the sky told them to do. And that was, don't stand there gape mouth like that. Go do something. Go recreate what was really important in a whole new way. And so the followers of Jesus did.
The Avengers.
They did just that. Even though Jesus was no longer physically present with them, they went out into the world and they recreated a new type of living Jesus. And that new type of living Jesus was in them. They became the Jesuses in the world. And we are invited to continue that. So we are now the body of Christ. We are now Jesus in the world. And the way that we act is a way to be like Jesus in the world and the choices we make. So that's why the story is really, really important. It's to remind us we can either stand there and be sad about what we've lost, or we can turn around and get busy and recreate what we've lost in a whole new way that brings life to all those around us. That's a big, big challenge.
No.
Well, Well, my friends, we are going to do thumbprint postcards today. What do you think those
are? What
are
those for?
Do you know what those are? Thumbprint postcards?
No. Sometimes, yes.
Sometimes. Okay. Well, the idea is we have these postcards. What's a postcard? It's the old-fashioned way of texting, absolutely. So we can write somebody's address here, and we write a message here. And on this side, we're going to put a picture. And we're going to use our thumbprints and our fingerprints to make pictures today. And then if we want to, we can add some extra stamps to it. But the idea is first to get our thumbprints. Because what is special about our thumbprints? What do you know about your thumbprint?
They have circles.
They have, some of them have circles.
Mine has circles.
Yeah, mine has swirls. What does yours have? A little bit of swirls as well. Everybody's swirls. Thumbprint is completely unique to themselves. So when we make this thumbprint postcard, it will be completely unique to us. And then we can send it to somebody. Isn't that kind of neat? So we're making thumbprint postcards to remember that we are unique and special, and to create a piece of art out of that. So you can make any kind of creature using your thumbprints. How might we do that? You guys are really creative, so I'm gonna let you guys figure out what can we create using our thumbprints on our postcard. So to do this, we have our postcards. We have it's just a piece of paper cut in four, and on one side we've put a line with an address. On the other side we've kept it blank. We have some stamp pads that we can use. We're using washable ones so that they come off more easily. And then you need your thumbprint, so not a lot of supplies. If you happen to have other stamps at home, then add those. But it's pretty simple, and I just leave it up to the creativity of you guys. Start with your thumbs. Let's see what you can create with your thumbs and fingerprints. So we have some cool creations here. Do you guys want to show off your creations? Hold them up. Eli has created a person out of his thumbprints. Madeline has a beautiful tree with an owl and a frog. I've done something similar, but it looks still really different, doesn't it? That's really cool. And so who can we send our postcards to?
Grandma and
Grandpa. Grandma and Grandpa. We haven't seen them in a long time, have we? And so we can put their address and a stamp on the back, and we can send it to them to say hello, because they're not very good on the computer either. So that's an awesome idea. And Madeline, who are you going to send your postcards to?
Daddy.
To Daddy. Daddy will like it as well. Daddy's just downstairs, but he's still going to think it's pretty cool. And maybe I can send mine to Omi and Papa?
Do I put a stamp right here?
Yeah, we're going to put a stamp on the back, and we'll put the address, and we can write a little note to say, we miss you, and we love you, and we're thinking about you. And so that is our thumbprint art to keep us connected to others this week. We'd love to see the kind of pictures that you've created. Remember that it doesn't just have to be one thumbprint. You can use your fingers. You can use your fingers in all different kinds of ways to create different shapes in your art. I'd love to see what you create with your thumbprints. We'll see you next week, everybody. Enjoy the week and the beautiful weather that's coming.